it's actually never included in the practice tests because they can't release those questions publicly or else they wouldn't be able to reuse them on a future gotcha. Exam. So it's possible that, let's say someone took the LSAT in 2009 and they took it with an experimental section as it was administered back then on paper, that section may have then been re-administered in 2011, but this time as one of the actual scored sections. And so then maybe in 2012, it was released in a book, but it wasn't counting while it was administered initially. And they're not releasing them as experimental sections. And so students will need to kind of have to mix and match exams in order to get the four section experience if they were using a flex exam. But funny historical footnote that now it becomes relevant is that because the LSAT used to be five sections, including experimental section, four of which were scored, you now have tons of four section exams from that old format you can use. Those four section exams had two scored logical reasoning sections. So if you want to simulate a four section LSAT with logical reasoning as your experimental section, you can just use those. Thanks for tuning into the show. Please subscribe if you haven't done so already to be notified of new episodes as I release them. And feel free to reach out if you need anything at all as you move forward with your prep. I'm happy to help however I can. In the meantime, I wish you all the best and take care.